Hello guys, we are back with our next set of video lectures. In this set of series, we are going to start the subject Automata Language of Computation, and in some other colleges or some other syllabuses, it is also called as Theory of Computation. So both of the syllabuses contains of complete theory about automata, and the problems will be really interesting, guys. So in this lecture, we'll be going through the introduction and what are the basic structural representations of this automata. Okay, so basically the main use of automata is nothing but it says the efficiency or how efficiently a problem can be solved. So if there is a problem or an algorithm, so it can judge that whether it is going to give a solution or not. Like that, it's going to give you the in detailed idea. So here we'll be having many things, guys. Like there are DFA, NFA, and there are many things which will help us to do all those things. So we'll be going through them. And we also have the concepts of grammar. It's not English grammar, but it's a type of grammar which is used by compilers in compiler construction and many things. So basically, automata. Automata is nothing but the theoretical computer science plus discrete mathematics. So it is a combination of theory and the structures. It is nothing but a finite automata. So the applications of finite automata, I have told you that it gives the efficiency of a problem. So it can be used in both softwares and hardwares. And when we design compilers and many other softwares, they will be using the concepts of automata. Like they will be constructing the automata and they will be analyzing the things. Okay, so now let us go through the basic representations, structural representations, guys. So basically the representations are nothing but the grammar and the regular expressions are the two important notations that play a major role in study of automata and their application. So we can represent any kind of automata in terms of grammar or in terms of a regular expression. Fine. Okay, so now let us go through a small line of introduction about grammar. So grammar is used for software designing. So as I have told you, for compiler designing, whenever you want to create a compiler, we'll be using this grammar as a backend. Okay, and regular expressions. Regular expressions denotes that the data is especially in the text strings. So writing in terms of words. I hope everyone knows about sets. So in sets, we'll be writing S belongs to S, like that. We'll be writing many statements, right? So even we can represent in terms of these alphabets and everything using this. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through the main concepts of automata theory. Thank you. Thanks for watching.